Welcome to my channel, The Biology Key. Everyone wants to be fit and fine. For that, what is the most important thing which we need to do to get a proper shape, a proper structure of a body? Yes, we need to do exercise. We should have a proper diet, do a gym regularly. So these are the things which we do. Now these activities, when we are performing, we are bringing about change in our morphology. So this is nothing but a type of Lamarckism. Now let us see what is Lamarckism, who coined it first, and what are the examples of it. So let's get started. Lamarckism was proposed by Jean-Baptiste Lamarck. According to him, the two most important theories of Lamarckism includes, the first one is use and disuse of organ, and the second one is inheritance of acquired characters. Use and disuse of organ is nothing but an organ develops because of the specific activities that the organism performs. If such organ is not used, it gets degenerated. If suppose there is an organ in your body which you are not using, this specially happens in animals. If they are not using that particular organ, it totally becomes degenerated. Degenerated means it disappears or it becomes totally inactive. Whereas if you spontaneously or we continuously use a particular organ, you will find that that particular organ becomes more stronger, or it becomes enlarged, or it becomes highly active than the another organ which is being less used. So this is nothing but the first theory, which says use and disuse of organ. The examples of use and disuse of organs are as follow. The first and the most common example is the neck of the giraffe. If you see the neck of the giraffe in the olden times, earlier the giraffe had a very small neck. But later on what happened is the giraffe wanted to eat the foliage from the trees. Foliage is nothing but the leaves from the trees. So what the giraffe used to do? Used to try to reach the leaves. Because of that, the neck started stretching, and due to the excessive stretching of the neck, slowly and gradually evolution took place and the neck actually got elongated and became big. The second and the most common example is the iron smith. Iron smith keeps on hammering the iron, and due to this continuous movement of hammer, their arms becomes really very strong. For example, if your mother is cooking food, she will not have such a strong arms as compared to the iron smith, because they are continuously using hammer. Then another example is the wings of the ostrich, then emu. These birds, like ostrich, they hardly use their wings because they mostly walk, and ostrich is the fastest running bird. So because of the excessive use of legs, the wings of these birds became weak. Another example of the birds are the swan and the duck. Now these birds lives in the water. Because of that, they need to keep on swimming. So for the swimming, they use their legs. All these modifications was all about the use and disuse of organ. Another theory which Lamarck brought about was that this acquired characters which is brought about in the organism is transformed from one generation to another, and such a process is known as inheritance of acquired characters, or you can say the Lamarckism. Development of organs due to specific activities or their degeneration due to no use or widely used was accepted. The first theory of Lamarck was highly accepted by the people, whereas the second theory was completely rejected. Inheritance of acquired characters was completely rejected because only the genetic characteristics are transmitted from one generation to another. And therefore, this was a drawback of this theory. So this was all about Lamarckism. Thank you.